Okay, so Microsoft Forms has preset features on how to create a quiz. We're going to do a full walkthrough of the different question types and show you how to use them all and then how to send them out to your students. So we're going to start out at just office.com. And once you get into this screen, we'll go to Forms. And if you don't see it on this main screen, left click on All Apps, and then you should see it there. We'll left click on Forms. And you have the option to create a new form or a new quiz. So make sure you choose new quiz because this will be tailored to a quiz instead of a survey. And then we'll go up and just customize the name of it. So for this one, we'll say Math Week 3. And as a description, we'll say addition. This is going to be a relatively basic quiz as far as math goes, but we'll keep it nice and simple. It'll be easier to put it together. So left click on Add New, and this is just going to bring you to adding your first question. And you have several choices here. We're going to go over a few. A lot of these are more relevant for surveys, so we're just going to go over the couple of different types that you're likely to use for a quiz. And the first one would just be what they're calling choice, which would be multiple choice. So we'll left click on that. And below, it brings you to a couple of fields that you can fill out to do your question. And for this one, though, we're going to be doing math questions because that's going to help us show you the extra abilities it has for math. So we'll say, please complete the equation. And we'll come down into the lower right-hand corner. We'll left-click on these three dots, and there's something here that just says math. So when you left-click on that, you're telling Microsoft Forms that it's going to be a math question. It gives you this extra bar where it says enter an equation. When I left click in here, I get this drop down that gives me all of these mathematical functions. And we're going to keep this one simple, like we said. So we'll just say 4 plus 3. Left click on OK. And that's going to suggest a correct answer. Since this is a computer, hopefully it can do simple addition. So we're going to trust that that's right. And it's suggesting other ones that you can also add as a shortcut. You can, of course, change these if you want, but let's just left click on add all, and the question's done. It's made it for you already, and it's already selected what it thinks is the correct answer. So you can change that correct answer if you want, but we're just going to leave it. You can move these around. So if you don't want the correct one at the top, just left click on the handle here and drag it down. You can also leave some feedback. So if it's 18 and you want to tell the student, or 12, let's say, oops, you multiplied instead of added. That feedback will pop up if they accidentally select that answer. It's wrong and won't give them points, and it will tell them a little hint so that they get it right next time. Some other options that you can configure on this screen is that you can require more than one answer. So you wouldn't typically do that on a math problem, but if there's some type of problem where maybe two of them are right, you would move this slider over to the right, and then you can designate more than one correct answer. You can make the question required. So if it's a really long quiz, and maybe by the end you're expecting the students not to get through all of it, you cannot make some of them or all of them required, and then they can submit it without them completed. And we assign a point value to it. So let's just say 10 points. So if they get that right, it's going to add 10 to their total points. And a few more options down here on the right will be, you can add branching. So there is, when you go to the green button that says add new, one of the choices is sections. And I'll link to a video that gives you more information on branching. But basically what this is, you can bring the student to certain different sections in a quiz based on how they answer the questions. So for example, if you want them, if they keep missing questions, if you want to bring them to an easier section, you would use this, you would add branching, and you would have a new section with easier questions on it, and you would direct the student to that section. All right, let's show you a couple more questions, and then we will preview the form. So it's suggesting another question. It's just trying to save you some time. And it's suggested three more. Let's just take one of these. We'll do add selected, and it just already pre-populated that entire question. So it has that AI built in, save you some time if you want to use it. And So let me back that up and explain what I was doing. We're going to add new. We're going to do a different type this time. We're going to select text. And what that is the student would answer in a text field, which you would grade. So let's just say, it's hard to, in a math quiz, let's say, what's it called when you take the difference of two numbers? Okay, so the answer is going to be, it says enter an equation. So we need to turn math off for this one. We'll left click on that to turn it off. Now it just says enter a subtitle. You don't have to do that. We'll skip that. Enter your answer. Now that stays there for the student. We need to come down and add an answer. We're going to say subtraction. This one is 15 points. It's a little bit harder, we'll say. You can make this a long answer where you just give the student a little bit more room to answer the question. We'll uncheck that for now. And we're going to add a new question and we'll look at a few others. The rating is more for surveys, so you can ask your student to rate something in quiz if you want, but we're not going to go over that. A date. So this will give you a date picker. So when the student answers the date question, it will only accept a valid date. So let's add that. And we're going to look at this when we preview this in a minute. We'll say, when was math invented? And another answer type that you can do. So you can ask your student to rank different questions. That's more of a survey. We won't go over that. I'm going to link to another Microsoft Forms video that has more descriptions of the question types. So you can look at that if you want. But you can also allow your student to upload a file. So if it's an open-ended question where it says, show me your diagram that you drew, or upload a picture of the drawing that you made, you would do this and it will create a folder for them to upload. So we're ready to look at this right now. Let's go to preview. So left click on that. Student comes in and please complete the equation. 10 points, 4 plus 3, we'll say 7. We're going to purposely get this next one wrong. We'll say 13. What is it called when you take the difference of two numbers? We'll say subtraction. When was math invented? We'll say yesterday. And to upload a file, you would left click on the upload file, and this is just looking at my computer. The student could also go to their OneDrive to pick the file, and we'll click submit. And it says, thanks. So let's come in here as the teacher. Well, you're still the teacher because you're just previewing. Left click on view results. And this is going to show you how this student did. Now you'll notice that the date question isn't graded yet. So dash out of 15 points. And this is 0 out of 15 points. Let's go back on the back arrow. And when you download this, after you send it out and you gather responses, which we haven't gotten to yet, you can open it in Excel. And at that point, you can enter the scores for the items that you weren't able to score in Microsoft Forms. You don't have to grade these as the form goes along. You can grade them afterwards because you get a spreadsheet with all the answers in it. So the next thing that we want to look at is themes. It's just easy. You can just change the way your form looks. Let's just choose this nautical theme, you know, because that goes with math, right? And then what we want to do though is go through settings. So some of these are important because you'll want to control the way that your quiz works, and understanding these is the way to do it. So you can show your students the results automatically. So you could have told them whether those math questions were right or wrong. Turn that on or off. You can limit this form to only be answered by students that are in your organization, which is probably your school. So that's checked by default now, and it's going to record their name and only let them respond one time. So this is your traditional. You send it out to your students. You'll get all their scores. Each one will only take it once. If you want to open this up, then you can do anyone with the link can respond, and then you can send it out as a link and have anyone fill it out. You can limit this to start at a certain time and stop at a certain time, and you can shuffle the order of the questions. So there's a few other settings in there as well. And the last thing that we want to do is let's look at how to share it or send it out. So we'll left click on share. It's going to bring up some options. The first thing here is a drop down, And it's what we already talked about in settings. So it's checked that only people in my organization can respond right now. If I went back and changed that to anyone with the link, it won't let me change that because I have file upload here and it won't let you send it out if just anyone can upload a file. So let's turn this off. We'll delete this question for now. And let's go back to the settings. Allow anyone with the link to respond, and we'll left click on share. And then we're just going to leave this as anyone with the link. This is the link here. So you could just copy that and then send that out in an email, send it out in Microsoft Teams, however you want to do it. But you can also distribute this as a QR code. So if you have that image of the QR code, someone can scan it with their mobile phone and bring them right to this form. You can embed it in a website so the student can take this quiz in a website that you have. This is the code to embed it, or you can send it out an email. So when you left click on that, it's going to bring up your default email client. I don't have one installed on this computer, so it's asking me what to use. Well, I do have one installed, but I don't have it configured, what my preference is. But if you're a heavy Microsoft user, this will probably bring up Microsoft Outlook. All right, so that covers most of the Microsoft Forms options. Now let's talk about Microsoft Stream, where you can create videos and share them just inside your school. So I'll see you in that video.